them to a wilderness where great predators still roam. If you feel like an adventure back in time to Europe as it was hundreds of years ago, then this ultimate journey is just for you. Between the Danube and the Black Sea lies a world where animals and humans live in harmony. From mountains to valleys, farms to flowers, weather to wolves, our ultimate journey takes us to Bulgaria. Our journey begins in late March in the Pirin Mountains. These remote ravines offer shelter for persecuted wolves. The mountains are still locked in winter and food is scarce. For centuries, wolves have been heavily hunted, but Bulgaria's population of around 1,000 have recently been given state protection. Brown bears, too, have sought shelter in the hills. Rivers offer the promise of fish. But wherever there is food, no matter how meager, a fight is inevitable. While the mountains remain locked in winter's chill, spring slowly breathes life into the low-lying valleys. In many areas, financial constraints have prevented modernization. Oxen are still used to plow the fields, grueling labor for both man and beast. But the absence of modern machinery has created a fragmented landscape, providing corners for wild animals and plants. Despite the popular destinations of Greece and Turkey lying to its south, Bulgaria remains poorly known. To the north, the country borders with Romania and is shaped by the Danube plains and mighty mountain ranges such as the Rhodop and Balkan. The Black Sea lies to the east. But it's the 400-kilometer stretch of sandy coastline that has become best known. For millennia, fishermen have begun their work at dawn. The cold nights and choppy seas are worth overcoming for the marine riches. People working here rarely have time to look to the skies. But if they do, they might see the Via Ponticum, an aerial dual carriageway for migrating birds. Hundreds of thousands of white storks make the perilous journey from Africa to summer breeding grounds in the north. As the sun's strength grows, cold-blooded animals slowly begin to stir from their winter's slumber. This looks and moves like a snake, but in fact it's the armless and harmless glass lizard, a giant limbless slowworm. Here on the Balkan Peninsula, it's bathed in a warm, dry climate. Compared to the tiny homesteads of Bulgaria, the harbour towns of Burgas and Varna have several thousand inhabitants. Industry here has still some level of romance. A cormorant colony adds life to deserted pylons. Cormorants are agile marine predators and hated by fishermen for their skill in catching fish. They're persecuted as competition. But regardless of seabirds, fewer and fewer boats leave their docks. Today, fishing as a primary income has been replaced by tourism. This stretch of coastline, with its quaint old town and atmospheric alleyways, is becoming one of Eastern Europe's premier holiday destinations. However, for most travellers, exploration stops here on the beach. One of the more archaic forms of evening entertainment are the performing bears. Condemned to a life in chains, the bears are often malnourished and abused. For decades, animal welfare groups have campaigned to abolish this treatment of bears, and gradually they've all but disappeared from the streets. The bears' owners are usually Romani, families from Romania who in the past were known as gypsies. Forced to the fringes of society, it's not easy to make a living, which is why they continue to work illegally with the bears. As nomads, the families move from village to village, seeking fairgrounds where they can perform music or circus tricks to earn their keep. However, it is hardly a conducive lifestyle for the fair treatment of a bear. Only around half a dozen performing bears are left in Bulgaria. The rest have been rescued. Many have been taken by an organization called Four Paws to a purpose-built bear park where the tortured animals can rehabilitate and live out their days in comparative freedom. They also offer a key attraction to tourists who for the most part seem to appreciate bears being bears over them performing tricks. For the first time, these bears, stolen from their mothers as cubs, have a chance to mingle with their own kind and enjoy bear fun and games. It's surprising how quickly they bounce back from their chained history. In areas where rivers flow into the Black Sea, impenetrable forests create a fortress surrounding the beach. Traveller can visit this magical landscape is by boat. There's a legend saying that God forgot the Bulgarians when he created the world. And so, to make up for his mistake, he gave them a little piece of paradise. Middle-spotted woodpeckers have avoided the threat of snakes by tunneling their nests high into the trees, a safe haven where they can raise their young. Not all the animals here are native. Feral pigs patrol the forest floor. Having escaped their captors, several generations of swine have set up home. Strangely, this family seems to have adopted a stray dog. Pigs on the run, they can be quite an obstacle. But it's not just pigs on the move. This Romani family is preparing to move on again. A quarter of Bulgaria's 8 million people belong to an ethnic minority. The Romani are often considered vagrants because of their nomadic lifestyle. is one of the last travelling families remaining. Today, they prepare to head north towards the Danube, which is our next stop on this ultimate journey. The wide plains surrounding the River Danube are the lifeblood of the country, providing much of the agriculture. In early summer, the pasture becomes a sea of blooms. Ravines have been carved into the hills by erosion, now offering fortification for plants and animals, sheltering them from the cold winds. They make an ideal breeding site for bee eaters, brightly coloured birds that have spent the winter in Africa. They tunnel their way into the soft sandstone walls, watched by noisy European rollers. For several generations, foxes have exploited the canyons and their vast network of caves. The steep embankment offers sunbathing on fine days, but also shelter when the weather turns and offers protection from predators. These five pups are around 6 weeks old and only just beginning to explore their fertile home. They are unaware of sharp eyes watching from above. But the young eagle owl's not yet old enough to be any threat. At the moment, these chicks are more fluff than foe, but they will grow to be one of the largest members of the owl family and impressive predators. The bee eaters haven't been back in the country for long, but they soon get down to the complicated business of finding a mate. Noise and a touch of jousting make for a dramatic show. It's a prenuptial gift that will seal the deal. But first, the prize must be de-stinged by bashing it against a branch. He then presents the disarmed gift to his chosen one. Perhaps food is the way to a loved one's heart. Dazzling rollers also bear gifts, showing off their hunting skills. The progress of summer is marked by the ripening cornfields of the Danube Valley. Visitors would do well to explore the rocky valleys of Ivanovo. Hidden surprises can be found around the crevices. These rock monasteries date from the 13 and 1400s, decorated by Christian monks with scenes from the New Testament. These caves are now part of the world's cultural heritage. By midsummer, it's time for the hay harvest, an attractive scene. It appears almost leisurely, although again, all the work is done by hand. Throughout the valley, the fields are alive with farmers gathering their precious winter supplies. Much of it will be used to feed the farmers' prized livestock. Their horses, mules and donkeys. Work on the farm would be impossible without them. The villages of the Danube seem to have been locked in a time capsule for hundreds of years, a unique window on Europe's past. This woman's role in life is to tend her geese, which she does with the utmost care. This image of bygone days is not without its flaws. The idyll belies economic problems that tear the society apart. There is high unemployment and low incomes. It's especially tough for the elderly. Strangely, it may be the country's natural wealth that offers the best chance for economic growth. It is one of the few places in Europe where human activity has been limited, leaving much of its natural heritage intact. Sites like this, Syrian woodpeckers nesting in the center of the village, have the potential to draw bird watchers from all over the world. Their safaris to see rare species would bring much needed income to the villages and at the same time provide an incentive to preserve Bulgaria's landscape. In an orchard, another gem of the bird world, the golden oriole, has its work cut out feeding its hungry brood. Colourful members of the starling family, both parents work around the clock to keep their chicks well fed. With brighter plumage, it's the male bird this time, offering a generous helping of mulberries, although perhaps he's overestimated his chicks' appetite. While the male bird thinks about the next meal, the mother moves in to offer shade from the summer sun. By opening her wings, she creates a canopy, protecting the chicks from the worst of the heat. The area surrounding the village is so steep that most of it can't be cultivated, but it provides ideal habitat for shepherds to graze their sheep and goats. Sapling trees and bushes trying to establish themselves stand little chance against the hungry flocks. In this way, the domestic animals keep the area open, creating ideal hunting grounds for birds of prey. With a cliff nest full of chicks, long-legged buzzards must be constantly on the prowl, using their sharp eyes to spot prey on the valley slopes. It means that for the native ground squirrels or suslicks, it's time to be extra vigilant. The squirrels work together to keep an eye on the sky. And this time it pays off. It's a lizard that falls foul of the buzzard's claws. As soon as the danger passes, the suslicks go back to their feeding. Like all rodents, they have strong teeth for gnawing. Because of the amount of wear they get, the incisors never stop growing. But throughout the world, rodents find themselves at the base of the food chain and must constantly watch their backs. Passing goats flush out one of their chief enemies, a horn-nosed viper. This is Bulgaria's most poisonous snake and was lying in wait for a ground squirrel. However, the goats have inadvertently intervened, now putting themselves in danger of a bite. However, the goats don't seem to realize their perilous predicament, and their inquisitive natures finally drive the snake to find a quieter spot. As the goat herd moves on, they leave behind them a gift for the smaller creatures of the hills. Their dung is rich in minerals and nutrients, providing a feeding station, breeding site, a nursery for a host of insects, and fertilizer for the plants. The presence of goats preserves the habitat and creates riches for the insect community. And insects are abundant, and in turn support a wealth of predators. Birdwatchers thrill to see striking members of the shrike family. In this case, a woodchat shrike. The chick has been offered a juicy caterpillar, but doesn't seem to know what to do with it. Another member of the species, a redback shrike, lives nearby. The handsome male uses a favorite perch to scout for prey. Shrikes are sometimes known as butcher birds for their habit of hanging their larder on thorns to be eaten at their leisure. Dropping his catch is not going to impress the female, but to make up for it, he presents her directly with the rest. When the father woodchat returns with the next course, it's clearly an offering too big for the chicks to manage, so mother gladly takes it for herself. Back in the ravine, and the bee eaters have finally settled with new partners. But still, they seem to spend most of their time bickering. But to keep the relationship sweet, they continue to make gifts of food. Only once the male has kept his part of the bargain and presented food, will the female honor her side of the relationship. Already started working on a nursery, a hole tunneled deep into the cliff face. It will offer good protection when their chicks arrive in a couple of weeks. In the valley below, the fox cubs continue to frolic in the sun. Now 2 months old, they're becoming more independent by the minute. The mother fox spends longer away from the den, searching for food, leaving the cubs to amuse themselves. The eagle owl chicks are also spending most of their time alone. Their parents sleep through the day, in sight of the nest. Overadventurous fox cubs should beware. It's only when night descends that the kings of the valley reveal themselves. A fiercely powerful hunter, eagle owls can even tackle other birds of prey, but favor martens, mice, hedgehogs, and even young foxes. By morning, only four fox cubs remain. The fifth paid for its curiosity with its life. As stifling heat grips the countryside, weather systems sweep across the country. August is perhaps not the best time to visit. Dark clouds foretell thunderstorms. Wild flowers dance in the warm breeze. In the calm before the storm, the fields are bathed in golden light. But then the tempest strikes. With the ground hard, most of the water runs off, and in the Balkan Mountains, rivulets quickly become raging streams. The Danube Valley is about to flood. Torrents of water carry away the few possessions that these people own. Heavy flooding happens most years. The spectacular landscape might be a welcome sight for travelers, but for locals to enjoy its beauty, they must pay a heavy price. Just a few hours ago, this was a field of ripening corn. Now it's a playground for courting dragonflies and frogs. For non-swimming species, it's a battle to get clear of the rising water. A piece of firewood set adrift becomes a life raft to a greater mole rat. Not a mole at all, but a burrowing rodent, this creature's underground tunnels have been swept away. Stronger swimmers are able to head for submerged trees. The drenching may even work to the four-lined snake's advantage, as other exhausted animals may seek shelter on this tree and end up as its food. Air bubbles slowly rise from the ground as water seeps in, but it's a slow drainage. Storks drop in to pick off frogs and toads that have come into the open to enjoy the water. But by the following morning, there is little trace of the rain. The Balkan Mountains enjoy a more balmy climate. This is a beautiful spot for a journey. Few people inhabit these hills, but as a result, the wildlife thrives. Mouflon, or wild sheep, arrived here from the Mediterranean, but seem particularly at home. The mountain slopes are too steep for cultivation, and only a few paths have been cut into the forest. For many families in Bulgaria, the forests offer the only source of building materials and fuel. The country has no true timber industry. Instead, people harvest what they need by hand, using draft animals to carry the heavy loads. This gentle utilization of the forest has enabled both animals and people to share the trees. In many parts of Europe, wildlife has been pushed out to make way for people. But here, wildlife remains and thrives. The trunks are bound, ready for horses to carry their heavy burden down into the valleys. The trails through the woods lead to some of the few roads, and at this point, lorries can take over. Mountain villages move at their own pace. Visitors to the country can expect to see monasteries towering over almost every village and surrounded in lush virgin forest. Black storks seek shelter in the trees. Unlike their white cousins, they're shy and secretive, seeking nest sites deep within the forest. Once they reach maturity, the storks will find a mate and remain with that same partner for life. Jet setters, these favorites of bird watchers, overwinter in Africa before trekking back to Bulgaria in spring to start new families. Both parents play an equal role in nursing the chicks, each taking shifts. One flies off in search of food, mostly frogs and other small animals, while the other stays behind to tend the nest. Bulky hawfinches have a more open nest site. The parents have easy access to the perfect baby food. Caterpillars are nice, soft protein-rich goo wrapped in handy green skins. The parents have quite a different diet, using their stout beaks to crack seeds and grain. Unlike many birds, the chicks remain silent when feeding to avoid drawing dangerous attention to the nest. Next, we travel west along the Balkan Mountains, close to the borders of Serbia and Romania. These are the sandstone rocks of Belograd chick. Towering several hundred meters into the air, the peaks have long inspired travelers, and many have religious names, such as Madonna with Child or the Monks. In Bulgaria, there are more than 2,000 caves, many of which can be found here. This cavern leads 1.5 kilometers deep into the heart of the mountains. A little river runs within, fed by 14 clean water springs. When dusk falls, a new air fills the cave. It seems to bring the rocks to life. Countless bats clamber on the walls. Having spent the day sleeping upside down, the mothers now leave their young ones in a creche and prepare to head out into the night sky to hunt insects. However, by first light, the flocks have disappeared without trace, back to their lair in the mountains. To the south of the Balkan Mountains lies the Valley of Roses. These most precious of blooms are harvested only during the cool morning hours, when oil concentrations in the flowers are at their peak. Amazingly, 80% of the world's roses are produced in this Bulgaria valley. Soil type and climate combine to create a rose bed paradise. It takes a staggering 2,000 blooms to yield a single gram of attar of roses, an expensive ingredient of the most noble perfumes. These flowers of love have brought modest wealth to people in the valley. A good cause for celebration. A time of singing, dancing and music, decked in traditional costume. Dressed in their finery, the women of the village compete for the title of Queen of the Rose. But don't be lulled by the beauty and forget the thorns. The celebrations last for 5 days, time for young people to make new acquaintances. These parties have taken place for decades, but the methods of recording them have changed. On the most southern border of Greece, we venture to another mountain range. In contrast to the Balkans, here water is scarce in the Rhodope Mountains. The climate is hotter and drier than in the north. Songbirds seize every opportunity to bathe and cool down. Insects and reptiles rely on the sun to heat their bodies. The horned viper is just one of four poisonous snakes in the country, although the more conspicuous leopard snake is completely harmless and is often considered the most beautiful species in Europe. It preys on rodents and young birds. Stag beetles would be an unlikely snack, and for this aggressive male, it is a rival that offers the greatest cause for concern. The Rhodope Mountains offer a rough, tough beauty. The poor soils are not good for crops. Gradually, some of the settlements have become deserted. Turkish-born immigrant families, in particular, have packed up and returned to their homelands. The few that remain eke out a meager living growing tobacco plants. Harvest begins in the middle of the night to avoid the torturing midday sun. It's arduous work, but vital to keep the local economy afloat. Leaf by leaf, the tobacco is gathered by hand. Women thread the harvest together into chains ready to be dried. Cattle seem to roam unbounded throughout the mountains. But here, they're under constant surveillance. There is a lot for any explorer to discover in the Rhodope Mountains, such as the so-called Clough of Trigrad. Here, there are mysterious stone archways. Also, this is a region rich in ancient custom and tradition. This area, one of the poorest in Bulgaria, is inhabited by another minority group. While 85% of all Bulgarians belong to the Christian Orthodox Church, some of the mountain villages have mosques. Percent of Bulgarians are Islamic, although only a few, the Pomaks, have the classic blonde hair and blue eyes that go with it. Journeying into the Pirin Mountains, we can view the whimsical sand pyramids of Melnik. Eons of rainfall have carved them from the cliffs. On the exposed rocks, animals have disappeared, retreating from the heat. But a few hardy species have made this their home. This is one of the few places where humans rarely stray, and for that reason the wolf has established itself here. Adaptability enabled the wolf to colonize these harsh outcrops, whilst throughout the rest of the continent its relatives were being wiped out. It's the ultimate sight for any wildlife enthusiast, and few tourists may be lucky enough to get a glimpse. Secretive birds like the nutcracker, a relative of the crow, thrive in the cooler alpine climate. It's so much cooler here that in some years, winter snow doesn't completely thaw, a permanent reminder of the cold times that lie ahead. In the mountains, the summers are short. It only takes a few weeks for winter to close in. The rivers will freeze, and the dazzling blooms of this season will wither and die in preparation for the snow. From sun to snow, it's a typical reflection of a land of contrasts, a unique opportunity to enjoy unspoilt wildlife and witness age-old culture. There are so many faces to this little-known country, and for that reason, a trip around Bulgaria has to be one of the most ultimate journeys.